जैनापुरे, भाग्यश्री, भक्ति, भारती, चेतन कुमार इज देयर, ओके, दीपक, दिव्या, कटपत में शिवाजी, ज्योति,
प्रेजेंट सर।
ओके, किरण, लक्ष्मीकांत, मानतेश, मोले प्रेम, ओके, नागेश, मोले प्रेम इज नॉट देयर, नागेश, नंदीश, पूजा, प्रमोद कुमार, रवीन, प्रियंका, संध्या, संतोष पुजारी, संतोष सोनार, शाहबाज, शफिया, श्रीधर, सृष्टि, सिद्धार्थ, सिद्धार्थ पाटिल, सुप्रिया, वंदना, वसंत, वेदत्ता, योगेश, महेश, ओके, महेश, बालेश, तैक
यस
मामा, ओके, प्रवीण,
सर,
अभिषेक,
योगेश
अभिषेक,
प्रेजेंट सर।
ऐश्वर्या, ओके, ऐश्वर्या, अमानुल्ला, बंडोड़ का तनय मोहनदास, भावराव, शोधन, ओके, देवाना अनिल कुमार, शेखप्पा, आनंद कुमार, प्रमोद, रोहिणी, रोहित, शशिधर, ओके, श्रीधर, स्नेहल, वैष्णवी, साईश, कार्तिक, ओके। Are you able to see the screen? Screen is visible.
Yes,
Screen
sir.
is visible. Okay. In the last class, I was discussing about the initializing and accessing timer registers. Now, first we have to load the which timer we are using, which mode we are using. That we have to load into the timer register tmod. For example, if the timer that we are selecting is the timer 1, that is upper 4 bits, and mode 1, then the bits will be 0001. Gate is 0, software mode, C slash T bar, it is 0. Okay, next bit, it is timer. Then 01 means it is mode 1. Then timer 0 we are not using, so the remaining 4 bits are zeros. So what is the value here? 0001, then 40, so it is 10H. Move tmod comma hash 10H. Then we have to store the starting value that the timer has to count in TH and TL registers. For example, if you want the count of 100, then we have to store 100 for 100 microsecond, that is time, we have to load 100 value in the TH and TL registers. That means we have to store minus 100 or FF9CH. If we subtract FFFF minus 100, minus 100 is in decimal, you have to convert it into hexadecimal. So FFFF minus 64, 100 in decimal is equivalent to 64 in hexadecimal. So FFFF minus 100, that comes out to FF9B. FF9B plus 1 you have to add, because one clock pulse is required for counting from FFFF to 0000. So it comes out to FF9CH. Then store these values in TH and TL registers. Upper high 8 bits is FF. Move TH1 comma hash 0FFH, and the lower 8 bits is 9C. Move TL1 comma hash 9CH. Then start the timer using the instruction set bit TR1. Start the timer. Once the timer starts, then it will go on counting from FF9C, FF9D, FF9E like this up till FFFF. After FFFF, there will be overflow condition. This is the instruction which is meant to check the overflow condition. Wait colon JNB, jump if no bit TF1 comma wait. If there is TF1 equal to 0, then it will jump here itself. When there is overflow condition, TF1 will become equal to 1, so it will come out of the loop. Then stop the timer using the instruction clear TR1 and clear the overflow flag for the next round of operation. Okay, so these are how we are programming the timer registers for providing the timing operation. This is mode 1 programming. Starting value, suppose if it is FFFC, then it goes to FFFD, FFFE it counts, FFFF, then after FFFF it goes to 0000. This is overflow condition. Here we are starting the timer. FFFC it counts to FFFD. We are starting the timer by using the TR register. Timer run control bit, TR 0 for timer 0. Make it 1 so that it will start to count. Then TF overflow flag is 0 here, it is also 0. Right. So when the timer goes from FFFF count to 0000, the overflow flag TF will be set to 1. Then we have to stop the timer. To stop the timer, we are making TR not bit equal to 0. Right. So this is how we are monitoring the overflow flag, timer overflow flag TF. Then the operation is described by this diagram. We are applying the clock pulses from the crystal oscillator. Right. That is clock pulses that is divided by 12. Suppose if the crystal frequency is say 11.0592 megahertz, that divided by 12, that gives the clock frequency for the timer. So these clock pulses are applied to the AND gate. Then the TR bit, timer run control bit, is made high. So clock pulses when it is 1, when it is high, TR bit when it is high, so 1 into 1 is 1, the output of AND gate is 1, the timer starts to count. Suppose if the starting value is FFFC, then it will count FFFD, FFFE, FFFF, then it will go to 0000, where the overflow flag TF will be set to high. Okay. So this diagram describes the mode 1 programming. Okay. So in examination, they may ask, explain the mode 1 programming operation. Then you have to draw these two figures and you have to explain, also explain this initializing and accessing the timer registers. That is the different steps. First step, what is the first step, second step, third step, fourth and fifth steps. Okay. Let us take one program. Write a program to create 50% duty cycle on P1.5 bit. Timer 0 is used to generate the timer delay. So we have to generate a duty cycle of 50% square waveform. Okay. 50% duty cycle square waveform. So if it is 50%, then it is square waveform only, is it not? On period is equal to off period on the P1.5 bit. That means you have to complement every time P1.5. Okay. So if you are making P1.5 1, it should remain high for say some time, then it will go low, then it will remain low for some time. Okay. On time should be equal to off time. That is 50% duty cycle. Then they are asking to use timer 0 to generate the time delay. Okay. So we'll write a program for this. So first is you have to load the TMOD register, move TMOD comma hash 0101. This is for upper 4 bits are 0, right? Then lower 4 bits is 0001. That means timer 0 is used in mode 1. What they have mentioned in the statement, timer 0 should be used to generate the timer delay. That is lower 4 bits, right, is for timer 0, upper 4 bits is for timer 1. Then the next instruction, you have to load some starting value in TH and TL registers. TL 0, comma, hash, any starting value you can load, right, here I am storing 0F2H in TL 0 register, timer low register. Then in TH not register, timer high register, I'm storing the value hash 0FFH. Okay. That means what is the starting value here? FFF2. The starting value will be FFF2, starting value. Okay. So from this starting value, it will start to FFF2, FFF3, FFF4, like this it will count up till FFFF. Okay. So once we are loading the starting value, we have to complement the P1.5 to generate the square waveform. Okay. Then we are calling the delay because they're asking to generate 50% duty cycle using timer 0 to generate the time delay. So call the delay function. Then in the delay function, we are writing delay. How to provide the delay? Now time delay is provided by the timer. Timer 0, which is operated in mode 1. Timer 0 is operated in mode 1. That will provide the time delay. Correct? So now, what are the different steps in initializing and accessing the timer registers? First step is load the TMOD register. Second step, load the TL0 and TH0 registers. Right? Then third step is start the timer using the instruction set bit TR0. For timer 0, it is TR0. For timer 1, it is TR1. Is it not? Then again, we have to repeat it. We have to monitor the overflow flag. For that, we have to use the instruction JNB TF0, again. Right? Then once the overflow condition occurs, we have to clear the overflow flag. We have to clear the overflow flag. Clear TF0, and also clear the timer run control bit. TLR TR0. Then RET, return. Okay, so it will provide a delay of certain delay, which is on delay, because first time we are complementing. Suppose it goes from 0 to 1, it is remaining high for this much amount of delay. That is, that delay is given by from FFF F2 to FFFFH. Okay, then once it returns, so it will return to the next instruction after the call instruction. Then we are giving SJMP here. It has to repeat. So from what value it has to repeat? It has to load the timer TL0 and TH0 registers every time, and it has to come from that value so that it generates a delay. Okay. So when it counts again, when it loads the TL0 with the F2H, that is TL0 will be equal to F2. TH0 will be equal to FFH. Again, complement P1.5. So complement P1.5 means the first time it was 0 to 1 transition, it remained high for certain delay, which was given by this timer delay. Okay. Then next time it is complement P1.5. It goes from 1 to 0. The pulse will go from 1 to 0. Then again call delay. So this delay program will be executed. It will generate the delay again, which is given by FFF2 to FFFH. Okay, so every time you are giving the clock pulses, it will go on counting by one count. When you are applying first clock pulse, it will count from FFF2 to FFF3. Second clock pulse, FFF3 to FFF4. Third clock pulse, FFF4 to FFF5. Like that, it goes on counting up till FFFF. Then from FFFF, it overflows and again goes back to 0000. So this is how it is generating a square waveform or 50% duty cycle on the pin P1.5. When they are saying to generate 50% duty cycle, you have to maintain on time equal to off time. That is important. That is obtained by giving the same delay, that is on delay is equal to off delay. That is provided by the same value of the timer registers. That is TH0 is FF and TL0 is F2. Both for on delay and off delay. Okay. So is this program clear here, students? Did you all understand this program? Write a program for generating 50% duty cycle waveform on P1.5. Use timer 0 to generate the time delay. Okay. So what these steps I told, if you remember these steps, okay, you remember these steps, right? That is, this accessing, initializing, accessing timer registers. If you remember these steps, then you will be able to write the program. Okay. Initializing, accessing timer registers. Is this program understood, students? Is it understood here?
Yes, sir.
Okay, right. Let us move on to the next example. Take down this example, students. In the above example, calculate the amount of time delay in the delay subroutine In the above example, calculate the amount of time delay in the delay subroutine generated by the timer. The delay subroutine generated by the timer, assume x tall is equal to 11.0592 megahertz. In above example, calculate amount of time delay in the delay subroutine generated by the timer. Assume x tall is equal to 11.0592 megahertz. Did you all note down, students?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now read the statement first before solving the example. What they are saying in the above example means this first program that is creating 50% duty cycle on P1.5 using timer 0 to generate the time delay. In this example, they are asking to calculate the amount of time delay in the delay subroutine. So whatever delay subroutine we wrote just now, in that program, how much time delay it is generating, that we have to calculate. Now to calculate that, they are asking to assume crystal frequency as 11.0592 megahertz. Okay, we have to calculate the amount of time delay in the delay subroutine generated by the timer to and assume that x tall is equal to 11.0592 megahertz. Now, which is the delay subroutine here? This is the delay subroutine. This is the delay subroutine. Okay. This is a delay subroutine. In this delay subroutine, how much delay it is generating? That we have to calculate. Right. Second example. Now, what is the crystal frequency that is given? Crystal frequency is x tall is equal to 11.0592 megahertz. 11.0592 megahertz, right? Then we have the clock frequency is given by 11.09592 megahertz, that is crystal frequency x tall divided by 12, x tall divided by 12. Okay. That is 11.0592 megahertz, this divided by 12, Okay. Calculate how much it is. 11.0592 megahertz divided by 12. Calculate the value. 11.0592 megahertz divided by 12. How much it is?
921.6 kilo.
Yes, 921.6 kilohertz. Kilohertz. Okay. 921.6 kilohertz. Okay. This is the timer frequency. Frequency of the timer. Okay. Timer frequency. All right. Timer frequency. Now, timer period, that is the period of the timer that is given by, that is each clock has a period of, the clock period is given by, each clock has a period of, each clock has a period of, what will be the time period? Frequency is 921.6 kilohertz, therefore time period will be 1 divided by f. 1 divided by 921.6 kilohertz. 921.6 kilohertz. 921.6 kilohertz. That comes out to how much? What is the value, students? 1 divided by 921.6 kilohertz is how much? Shodhan? 1.085 microseconds. 1.085 microseconds, right? Microsecond. Okay. So first, what we have to do? Crystal frequency, whatever they are giving. Suppose now, if they give the crystal frequency as 12 megahertz, then clock frequency will be equal to 12 megahertz by 12. 12 megahertz by 12. Okay. Whatever clock crystal frequency they are giving, that crystal frequency you have to divide by 12. That will give the timer frequency, and the time period will be given by 1/f. 1/f. Okay. That will give the clock period. Okay. Period of the clock. It is 1.085 microseconds. Now, once we are calculating the one that is clock period, the timer zero. So in the previous example, they have used timer zero. It counts up each 1.085 microseconds, 1.085 microseconds. It counts every 1.085 microseconds, right? Each 1.085 microseconds. So resulting in a delay of resulting in delay is equal to 1.085 microseconds into number of counts. Okay, number of counts. That is how many counts it is making. That multiplied by 1.085 microseconds. That gives the time delay. Right. For every one count, it is taking 1.085 microseconds. Therefore, the total number of counts multiplied by 1.085 microseconds. That will give the time delay. Correct. So now, how much count we are getting here? That we have to calculate. What is the value that we used? The starting value. Just to go back to the previous example and see. The starting value that we have used is FF F2 is the starting value that we have used. Okay. FF F2 is the starting value that we have used. So FF minus FF F2. Minus FF F2. So check how much you're getting. Keep your calci in hex mode. Perform FFFF minus FFF2. So it comes out to 0DH. 0DH. So in decimal, it is equal to 13. 13D. Okay. 13 in decimal. In decimal, it is 13. And in hexadecimal, it is 0D. Right. So we calculated the number of counts. So number of counts is 13. But one count is required. Please understand, try to understand the concept here. So 13 is the actual count, but one count it takes for overflow. So when it goes from FF to 0000, it will take one clock pulse. Therefore, how many total counts here? Therefore, total counts will be how much? Yes, please. What will be the total count? 13 plus 1. 13 plus 1. Total count, that will be 14. That will be 14. 13 is the actual count, that is FFFF final value minus starting value. Final value is FFFF minus starting value. FFF2, that is 0D, that is 13. One count it takes for overflow, that is from FFFF to 0000. Right? Therefore, total count will be 13 plus 1, that is 14. Therefore, what will be the time delay? Delay will be equal to how much? 1.085 microseconds into number of counts. 1.0585 microseconds into number of counts. That is 1.085 microseconds. 1.085 microseconds. 1.05 microseconds into 14. Okay. Is that how much you're getting? 1.05 microsecond into 14?
1.5.
No, in the microseconds. How many microseconds? 15.19 microsecond. Am I right? 15.19.
Right.
Okay. So 15.19 microseconds is the delay. Fine. Now, this is important. This 15.19 microseconds is generating half the delay. Right? We have taken the from where we started crystal frequency, that divided by 12, that gives the timer frequency. Then 1 by timer frequency gives the clock period. Okay. Then it counts for every clock, that is every 1.05 microseconds. 1.08 microsecond in 85 microsecond into number of counts, that gives a delay. So that we calculated by subtracting final value minus starting value, 0D, that is 13, plus one count is required for overflow condition. That is 13 plus 1, 14. That is 1.05 microsecond into 14 counts, right? That is 15.19 microsecond. This is generating half the delay. This is nothing but half the delay. 15.19 microsecond is half the pulse, right? For the timer, for the clock period, it is one full clock period. Try to understand here. So, but for the timer, it is half the pulse, half the, that is clock period, one clock it is, right? For the timer. So if we want for the total delay, the total actual delay, then what we have to do? We have to multiply this delay by 15.19 microsecond into 2. 15.19 microsecond into 2. Okay. 15.19 microsecond into 2. That gives the total actual delay. How much it is? 2 into 15.19 microsecond. 30.38 microsecond. Am I right? 30.1838 microseconds. Correct? 30.38 microseconds. Okay. So, well understood, students, how to calculate the time delay. Is it clear here? Yes. How to calculate the total actual delay? Is it understood? Is it understood here?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Let us take one more program. Note down this program here, this example. Assume that xtal is equal to 11.0592 megahertz. Assume that xtal is equal to 11.0592 megahertz. What value do we need to load into timer registers? Just one minute. So note down this statement, students. Assume that xtal is equal to 11.0592 megahertz. What value do we need to load into timer's registers if we want to have a time delay of 5 milliseconds? Show the program for timer 0 to create a pulse width of 5 millisecond on P2.3. Note down this statement. Assume that xtal is equal to 11.0592 megahertz. What value do we need to load into timer's registers if we want to have a time delay of 5 milliseconds? Show the program for timer 0 to create a pulse width of 5 millisecond on P2.3. Did you all note down this statement? Assume that xtal is equal to, crystal frequency is given 11.0592 megahertz. What value do we need to load into timer's registers? That means what should be the value of T-mod, what should be the value of TL0 and TH0 registers if we want to have a time delay of 5 milliseconds. If we want to have a delay of 5 milliseconds, what should be the value that we have to load into the timer's registers. Show the program for timer 0 to create a pulse width of 5 millisecond on P2.3. That means we have to use timer 0 to create a pulse width of 5 millisecond. Note that it is pulse width. It is not the total period. It is a pulse width of 5 millisecond on P2.3. Right? Did you all note down, students? Yes? Did you all note down?
Yes. Yes, sir.
Oh, right. When such programs are asked, first you are supposed to do the calculations, right? What is the calculation that we have to make here, right? Crystal frequency is given, x star is equal to, if they are not giving, then you can assume the crystal frequency as 11.0592 megahertz crystal frequency. So the timer, if it is 11.0592, we just noted in the previous example that the timer will count for every 1.085 microseconds, right? If crystal frequency is 11.0592 megahertz, then the clock frequency is given by crystal frequency divided by 12 and 1 by that frequency that gives the clock period. So that is 1.085 microseconds, right? That means the counter counts up, it is a timer counts up every 1.085 microseconds, every 1.085 microseconds, counts up every 1.085 microseconds, right? And how much pulse they are asking to generate? What is the delay of the pulse they are asking to generate? 5 millisecond pulse we have to generate on P2.3, okay? So if you want to generate a pulse of 5 millisecond, then so out of this 1.085 microseconds, we have to make a 5 millisecond pulse, right? Out of 1.085 microsecond, timing interval, right? We have to generate pulse of width. What is the delay of the pulse width? That is 5 milliseconds. So what we have to do here? Find the count value. Count value is given by count is equal to this value, that is pulse width on or off period, that is 5 milliseconds, this divided by the clock period, this divided by clock period, that is 1.05 microseconds. Okay. 1.05 microseconds. Find the value here, 5 milliseconds divided by 1.05 microseconds. How much you'll get? Just check this, 4608 clocks. 4608 clocks. Count is the on period or off period, that is 5 milliseconds divided by the clock period. T on or T off divided by the total clock period, that is giving the count, that is 4608 clocks. Follow this point here? Yes?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, this is 4608 clocks, right? Now, to find the value that we have to load into the timer registers, right? Load into TH and TL registers. Okay. So this is given by 65,536, that is FFFFH. If FFFFH is converted into decimal, it will be 65,536 minus 4608. This comes out to, just verify, 60,928. Convert this into hex. It will be EE00H. Is this value correct, dear students? What is FFFFH in decimal? 65,536. Right? 536. It is 65,536 minus 4,608. That will be equal to 60,928. Okay. So one clock pulse is required for going from overflow condition, that is FFFF to 0000. So this gives EE00H. This is the starting value that we have to store in the timer registers. That means in TH we have to store EEH, and in TL register we have to store 00H. TL register we have to store 00H. Okay. TH EE0H and TL it is 00H. Now we have to write the program. Now we have to write the program for this. So we require to do the calculation part. Once the calculation part is done, then we'll get the starting value that we have to store in timer registers. Then we will start to write the program. So what they have asked, to generate a pulse of 5 milliseconds. Clear? P2.3, we have to generate a pulse of 5 milliseconds on P2.3. Then load the TMOD and TH and TL registers, which timer we are supposed to use and which mode we are supposed to use, that we have to decide. They have asked to use timer 0, mode 1. What is mode 1? It is 16-bit mode. Mode 0 is 13-bit, mode 1 is 16-bit, mode 2 is auto reload timer, mode 3 is split mode timer. Correct. So move TMOD comma hash 01H. Then next is we have to load the TH and TL registers. Move TH 0 comma timer 0 we are supposed to use. TH 0 comma hash 0EEH. Then TL value is how much? 00. TH value is EE. TL value is 00. Move TL0 comma hash 00H. Once we load the starting value, then set bit complement 2.3. Start the timer. Set bit TR0. To start the timer, we have to use setbit TR0 instruction. And we have to monitor the overflow flag. The same steps what I discussed for initiating and accessing the timer registers. We have to monitor the overflow flag. JNB TF 0 comma again. JNB TF 0 comma again. Once the overflow condition occurs, we have to clear the 2.3 for the next, that is we are generating the clock pulses. First we are setting high, then we are giving the delay, right, using this EE00H. It will count from EE00, EE01, EE02, EE03, like this up till FFFF. After FFFF it goes to 0000. Then clear P2.3. There is, suppose if the initial value here we are given, clear P2.3, then it goes from low to high. Once this 8 bit P2.3 instruction is executed, it will go from low to high. Then after it, that certain delay that is given by EE00H value, we are clearing P2.3. Then after that, we have to clear the timer register, run timer run control bit, TR0 for next round of operation. Then clear timer overflow flag, TF0. The next round of operation. Okay, this is generating a pulse width of 5 millisecond on P2.3 pin. Okay, so is this program understood here? this program. Go through this. If you have any difficulty, you can ask. First part is calculation. You have to do this calculation part. You have to do this calculation part. Okay. This calculation is important so that you will come to know which is the starting value that we have to load into TH and TL registers. Then we have to load that starting value, whatever we have calculated, into TH and TL. Then set a bit P2.3, make it high, P2.3, where we want to generate the clock pulse or pulse width. Start the timer, monitor the overflow flag. Then once there is overflow, clear the pin P2.3 so that it will generating one pulse. Then clear the timer run control bit for next round of operation. Clear the timer overflow flag for the next round of operation. Is this understood here? Yogesh?
Yes, sir.
Shodhan, is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Jyoti? Okay. So any questions here, Shodhan? Any questions?
No, sir.
Okay. Yogesh?
Yes, sir.
Chetan Kumar, any questions? Chetan Kumar, any problem in understanding? Any problem in understanding these examples, these programs? Yogesh?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So in the next class, we'll discuss some more programs, right? In examination, they will ask such examples. Okay. First, you're supposed to find the starting value that we have to load into TH and TL. Once the calculation part is done, then we have to write the program. The steps we know. So these are the steps. Which are the steps? You have to remember these steps. Initializing and accessing timer registers. First, load the T mod. Depending on which timer you are using and which mode you are using. Then the starting value you have to load depending on the calculation, TH and TL registers. Start the timer, set bit TR1 or TR0. Then monitor the overflow flag using the instruction wait JNB TF1 comma wait or wait JNB TF0 comma wait. Stop the timer using the instruction clear TR1 or clear TR0 and clear the overflow flag clear TF1 or clear TF0 for the next round of operation. Right. Then we'll continue with some more examples in the next class. Okay. Thank you. Thank you.